Welcome to WebStarMS. There are so many ways you can declare functions in JavaScript or in React.js. You will see a lot of variations of function declaration and usage in different React.js projects. It's kind of confusing sometimes. In this video, we are looking into that. Also, how can you create functions quickly and what type of function should you use in components? First of all, if you use Visual Studio Code, install an extension named as ES7 React Redux React Native Snippets. Basically, search for ES7 React Redux Snippets and you will find it. This is the extension. It makes a React.js developer life easy. Scroll down and go to Snippets page. We've got the snippet link at the bottom. And here we have got snippets to use. Lot of useful snippets related to basic methods in JavaScript and related to React.js, React Native, Redux, prop types, and more. By using that extension, you can use shortcuts and create functions quickly in React.js. In React.js, we have stateful components, components with state. Then we have stateless components. Stateless components are also called dumb components. They are usually single responsibility components and they just receive data or consume data. We had class-based components before, but now with React.js hooks, we do not use class-based components anymore. We use function components or functional components. There are function components and functional components. These components use functions. Some of them use default export and some of them don't use default export. So should you create functions with default export or should you use functions without default export? What default export does? Answers are in this video. You will find out why do we use function components and why do we use functional components. Why do we use functions with default export and why do we use default export for some other components? Why do we import some components with curly braces and some without curly braces? What is the difference between function components and functional components? Why we use arrow functions? Why fat arrow? So many questions here, but after you watch this video, you will not be confused and you will be comfortable with these concepts. This is our main component for our React.js project or app. And okay, first of all, let's create a component with the default export. Components folder, new file. So this is a JSX file with name comp.jsx. We are creating React arrow function export component. Type RAFCE and hit tab. Now we don't need React import. Now this is a React arrow function export component. It has got the arrow, so it is arrow function and it is using default export. Let's import it. Import comp from components and comp. And this is how we will use it. Save. This is a component with default export. Pretty simple, right? Now I cannot import it with curly braces. It will not work because it has default export. It is being exported as default component. Functions with default export are not imported by using curly braces. Let's create another component file in components, new file. utilities.jsx. Now it has got a specific name, utilities. It is intentional and for a reason. inside this file, let's create a function. Type RAFC for React arrow function component. Hit tab. We don't need import. Let's name it title. We named it title. It has export, but not default export. Now this component will be imported with curly braces because it has no default export. Like import title from components utilities. And we can use it like this, and let's pass some data, simple title. And here, like this. Okay, that is fine. This component title was imported by using curly braces. And it is receiving a simple title or text. Let's create another similar function that will have another responsibility, single responsibility. Again, RAFC, React arrow function component. Let's name it conversion. Let's use a specific prop here and return an expression that will convert temperature. And then this function will need this information, this data. These two functions are similar. They have no default export and they are using fat arrow. Let's import this function within same curly braces. It's in the utilities and it will be imported in curly braces because it didn't use default export. So conversion, it needs some information. Let's use 100 here. So two components have been created in same file and they are not using export default and they are being imported using curly braces. Let's create another function without default export. This is React functional component. So this was function component. But this is functional component. And it will go like export function. Let's name it return. Simple expression, save. Now, this is not a function component. It's a functional component because it has got function keyword in it. It is not using default export. It is just export function and then function name. So we can import it in similar way in curly braces. Save, and here is the result. Okay, so you see similarities here in this file with these three components: function component, functional component without default export. These are components without a default export, so these are being imported in curly braces. And these are in a single file. And the file name is also utilities. Coincidence? No. Here is the takeaway. Use a utilities file. Keep small, single responsibility functions in it without default export. These will be imported throughout your application by using curly braces. This utilities file can have as many functions as you like, but without default export. These are like small utilities. These can be converters, small manipulations of data, where you can pass one thing and process it to get some desired result. Small utilities that app needs. Consider date and time manipulations that can be used at multiple places inside. Okay, so utilities file with multiple functions without default export. Now let's go back to our main component that has a default export. So this was React arrow function export component. There's a typo. We also have React functional components. Type RFC and press tab. We don't need a bold. Let's name it about. You see, a module cannot have multiple default exports. Another export default is here. So this is a functional component because it's got function keyword. No fat arrow here, and it is using default export like this function above. Now this cannot be used here. Why? Because we already have a component in the same file with default export. Only one default export component can exist in a file. Another default export component will not work. We can comment first one, then it will work. Now we can import it without curly braces because it has default export. Import about from components comp and then use it like this. Now we have another variant, React functional export component, type RFCE. It has export default and it is a functional component because it's got function keyword in it. But it will not work in this file because we have got another function that is using export default. So I'll just comment it. Now let me show you another thing. If you have a component with the default export like this one, you cannot use another default export in the same file, but you can use a function without default export in this file and import it. Like if we use a function without default export, it will work and it can be imported in these curly braces. But it's got different location now. Import from components comp. And now it is working. A component without default export in this file that is already using a function with default export or export default. So here are the takeaways. Function component is a component without function word in it, to put it simply. And functional component is a component that has function word in it. Functions with fat arrow are function components, and these are expressions. Only one function exported as default can exist in a file with the default export. A function that has default export will be imported without curly braces. A function without default export will be imported by using curly braces. As for why do we use fat arrow functions, the fat arrow syntax lets you omit the curly braces, these curly braces, and return keyword if you return the JSX directly. With ES5 functions, you must use return. Also, fat arrow functions are not hoisted because these are expressions. Like for this function with fat arrow, we can omit these curly braces and also return, and it will work. And we can move this line and use the whole thing in single line, and it will work. No curly braces, no return. Fat arrow allows that. And which syntax to use where? Okay, for a component with default export, use this syntax where default export is at the end, at the bottom of the function, using RAFCE, React Arrow Function Export Component. And for file like utilities, and for the functions without default export, use RAFC, React Arrow Function Component, this syntax, and use similar pattern across your application. So my recommendation is to not use this one. Ignore this syntax, ignore this syntax, and use this one, RAFCE and RAFC. So remember RAFC and RAFCE. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.